The sound of great music with virtuosi like Kreisler, Solomon and Dame Clara Butt was last heard here before the First War, by the time the curtain came down in 1940 to the strains of Maid of the Mountains. Elgar, Holst and Delius had all died in the same year. Blackheath and Britain in general was a land without music. The government took over the three concert halls. Until 1976, the main hall, which you could hire for 7 guineas in the 30s, was used to pay people on the dole. Now, 40 of today's unemployed are restoring the halls in a £1 million project to bring music back to Blackheath, and lots else besides. The scheme's being masterminded by the Blackheath Halls charity, using the Manpower Services Commission's Community Task Force.
It's a very splendid building. For many years it was taken away from local people and used as a ministry social security centre. And when news came that the ministry were going to quit, it was clear local people expressed themselves very forcefully that they wanted their building back. They wanted to use it again for its proper purpose as a concert hall.
And other things besides?
Oh yes, everything that people like to do gathered together in groups. Plays, meetings, any sorts of performance, even antiquarian book fairs. But of course the best news for us is that it's likely, very strongly, that the National Centre for Orchestral Studies will establish itself here as a teaching and performing base for a School of Orchestral Music.